What is up, guys? Welcome back to another video here on Loud and Proud. So we're actually in the shop here with the Mordecai 12 valve, and I'm gonna tell you why. I originally had thought about doing color match fourth gen mirrors and a color match grill. However, I have a wedding coming up in approximately a day. By the time you see this video, I will have already been married. I will be on my honeymoon and stuff, so I'm not gonna have like much time to do much more customization on this truck, because when I get back, there's only gonna be like a week left, and then this truck's supposed to be getting shipped off to whoever the winner might be. So also keep in mind, guys, you are down to the last 8 to 9 days left to enter to win this truck. Every $15 you spend on the Loud and Proud merch, that being hats, t-shirts, hoodies, keychains, decals, all that stuff, even the Rosine stuff, every $15 is another automatic entry win. And I also want to point this out. Every order that you place throughout the term of the giveaway gets added up and divided out by 15 for your total amount of entries by the time the end of the sweepstakes is over. So just so you know, if you make multiple orders and you're like, oh, that one was almost 4 entries, but it was only technically 3, and you make another order, you actually get everything added up, and then it's divided out to how many entries you actually get, so you get credit for every dollar spent. For the grill, I do have the sport grill. The problem being, I can't find any place that has like spray cans of that exact paint code. And I even called to Napa to see if they could mix me some. And I also called into a local body shop, and they're known for doing like super high quality work. And they're like, the earliest they could get me in is like 3 weeks from now to even do basic little color match parts. And then for Napa, they said that they could get me the paint, but then I'd have to take it to somebody to actually put it on the truck. So I'm like, well, that doesn't do me any good, because I can just call the place directly and have them make me paint, you know, themselves. So the whole process has just been a little bit sticky, and there's just like not many options. Yes, you can go online and buy like a $75 for like 2 little tiny cans of touch-up paint, but that's not like enough to do the grill, the mirrors, and all that stuff. So I'd still have to buy like, thinking $200 worth of, you know, paint, which is technically touch-up paint, to do that. And I just don't really want to bug around with that. So I'm probably actually going to just leave the grill how it is. I do have the sport grill, so whoever wins the truck, I will actually gift you the sport grill to take with you. And if you want to take the time to drop it off and have it paint match for, let's say, $150, $200, you can do that. But I just don't have time to get it done, and I don't want to, you know, do something with cheap paint and then put it on and it looks like crap, stuff like that. So if I can't get it done right, I'm just not gonna do it. And then in terms of the mirrors, we are gonna put the mirrors on, and I'm actually gonna leave the mirrors that are on it now with the truck in case somebody wants it. However, the fourth gen mirrors are just what I wanna put on it, because I feel like it'll be a better mirror for the truck. And what I mean by that is, when you're driving down the road, the glass on these, I don't know why, but they just shake and shake and shake and shake and shake and shake and shake. I don't know why. Second gen mirrors are notorious for that, and they have just always done that. Every second gen that I've had with second gen mirrors on it, well, technically like third gen mirrors, second/third gen mirrors on it, they always have shaky glass for whatever reason. So I just want to get these changed out, and the fourth gen mirrors have a better blind spot. So we're gonna have a better blind spot mirror. So we're gonna get the change in these out, and hopefully it looks really, really good. Well, we got the one side on and it looks really good. As you can see, a little bit different look, but it looks good. And then you got the other side, of course. There's your traditional second to third gen mirror on the truck, and if you look at it side by side, this mirror just looks a little bit better, not to mention it hasn't been faded out by the sun at all, so it's a nice dark black look on that mirror versus that one's more faded and gray. I think it's gonna look really good, and I cannot wait to see and show you guys the final product. I think you guys are really gonna like it. Okay. these mirrors really turned out super, super nice on this truck. And I always forget how good fourth gen mirrors do look on a second gen until I put them on a second gen, and then I realize how good they look. And like I said, the glass is just so much nicer on these mirrors than the other stuff. And if you go down into the description, I'm gonna try to leave the links to the mirrors down there for you guys. If you guys wanna pick up a set for your second gen or third gen or whatever, if you guys go to that link, and it'll basically give you the options to choose your models of trucks and whatnot. But I mean, they do look really good. No, I'm not gonna leave them up like that. I just did for the picture so you could see them side by side, but they do collapse very snugly, very easily. And then they do fold in like so and fold right back and lock into place. So a very nice mirror, very low cost. I think this set only costs like 150 bucks. And it can change the look of the truck for the better pretty quick. Right now, because this truck needs cleaned up, I know it doesn't look that dirty, but it's got a lot of dust on it from sitting in this dusty garage, and I need to make sure I maintain these wheels. They are ceramic coated, so they are very easy to clean, and they're not gonna like, you know, get real nasty on you quick. But I do need to go and clean this truck up and wipe down these wheels and get them all shined up so that the truck is all nice and clean again, so when I go to park it again, it's all nice and ready to be stowed away in top shape. So we're gonna go to the car wash right now and get this thing cleaned up, and let me show you what I'm talking about. So if you look at these wheels here, you can see this little bit of dirt and dust and grime and stuff like that. I'm not gonna touch it yet, but it does, it should just wipe off real easy. Actually, I'm gonna just take like a piece of my t-shirt and let me show you how that wipes off there. So if you see that, it got real shiny right there compared to right there. So it does come off real easy. So we're gonna get this to the car wash, and the rest of the truck is just, I mean, it's dust. There's some dust on it, but it's not like, it's not muddy, you know what I'm saying? It's not like a muddy dirty, it's just a little bit dusty. So we're gonna get this back over to the car wash, get it washed down, get it polished up, and get this thing in top shape so it's all nice and purdy again. So let's get it started up. Some people asking, you know, why go with an HX35? You know, if you had a turbo go out, why go back to an HX35? Well, the reason for that is, well, A, I don't really know exactly what turbo would fit back up in there other than an HX35. And I also know that the kit that the guy made was specific to that turbo. And I don't know all those slight variations and, you know, whatnot that could determine whether or not it would fit back in properly. And given that I'm gonna be out of town on my honeymoon and getting married and all this stuff, I'm not sure how much time I have to really test and fit and see what does and doesn't work. And I just wanted to go with the safe route and get a fully rebuilt, professionally done HX35 because I know that fits and I know it works. And I've talked to Jacob with Pusher and other guys like that who have ran compound turbos in these HX35s for a long time. You know, even like Jacob, he has a 700 horsepower 12 valve, and he said he's run that thing for almost 200,000 miles total of wear time on the turbo, and he said it's run amazing. So he said they can handle a lot of abuse and a lot of power. The thing is, this truck had 230,000 miles on it, and then 600 horsepower was thrown at it, and the turbo was never dealt with at any time. So that being said, now that the turbo is brand new and in the truck, there's really nothing to worry about. This turbo is going to last a long time, and the other turbo is already brand new, so you guys are all set. But that is the reason why I stuck with the HX35. I know it works, I know it fits, and I don't really have a lot of time to experiment with other options right now. Maybe we can get you guys a little turbo acceleration noise here. And that other little whistling sound that's off note is it's like the wind blowing in next to the mirror. And
that 6-7 was dumping some coal.
Well, we got the blue 12 out back here, all shined up.
You got the wheels all cleaned up here, all polished up again. Now we just gotta get this first shin cleaned up too. The wheels aren't the prettiest thing on it right now. It's been raining like crazy, so as you can imagine, rainwater ain't the greatest thing.
Probably got about 100 miles, 150 miles on that new rebuilt HX35 under the hood, and it's been running flawless. I mean, just absolutely amazing. I mean, way better than it ran before, I gotta say. Like, every time I get in, I'm just like, wow, this truck drives so much better. The boost pressure and pickup and get up and go time is just phenomenally improved. Like, just crazy amounts of improvement there. And the daily just drivability of it just like got way better. You used to not be able to even go down the road, and as soon as you touch your throttle, it's just like dumping so much smoke. I mean, it's just crazy, but much better. One more look at the truck with the new mirrors on it. Again, folded out so you can see how they look and how far they stick out. They don't really stick out much further than the other ones. It's just a different shape, more rectangular and boxy looking versus, you know, all the rounded edges and stuff. Trying to start the 7.3 today, and the 7.3 wouldn't start. So 7.3's just got a weak battery though, because it tried to crank but it just wouldn't, so that just needs a new battery. But guys, tell me what we should do for this truck. And I know this one's kind of been on the back burner of things because it's not like my top priority truck, because like the blue truck could be somebody else's truck, so that truck is more important to me to get perfect over than this one, you know, because it's not going to anybody. But like this truck, guys, I want to do wheels and tires on it, but I don't know what I want to do in terms of wheels and tires, because obviously the truck's kind of rough. It's not really a perfect truck. It needs some work, a lot of work. But I was thinking more of like sticking with some 16-inch wheels and maybe just doing like some 33s. You know, 16s and 33-inch MTs or aggressive ATs. And then in terms of the bed, we did, in fact, have it scheduled for a flatbed. But of course, we couldn't get the bed off, and so we couldn't take it. And that was like back in May now. So I'm going to try again to try to get this bed off. And of course, it was this. This is what the guys were telling me in the comment section, that there's a T50 bit size bolts you got to take out of the bed or grind them off. The problem with this being rhino lined is it is not going to be easy, and it's going to put up a lot of a fight. So this truck is just kind of a tough one to really get nailed down, especially now that it's getting really hot each day. Thank you guys so much for watching. Hopefully you guys did enjoy this. I know it wasn't a very long video, but hopefully you still got some entertainment out of it and you guys like what we did with the truck today. So do not forget to go down and check out the links for those mirrors if you guys are interested in those. But most importantly, the most important part of this video, do not forget that you guys are down to the last, I think it's like 8 or 9 days left to enter to win this truck. Every $15 is another automatic entry to win, and all of your orders are of course added up and divided out by 15 for the term of this giveaway, and that's how many entries you're gonna get. It's very simple. Just grab your favorite hat, hoodie, t-shirt, anything like that, and get entered to win this beautiful, beautiful truck and take it home. Thank you guys so much for all the love and support. That information is in the description below. Leave a fat thumbs up, subscribe if you're new, join the team, join the family, and I'll catch you in the next video. Peace.